Welcome to Adaxes. In this video, we'll be looking at exchange management and automation. The majority of those time-consuming tasks, like creating, configuring, and maintaining mailboxes in Exchange, are in fact completely repeatable, can be standardized, and thus can be easily automated. In addition to that, with Adaxes, you can simplify all sorts of exchange management procedures, making them more robust and reliable, which gives you the ability to securely delegate them, freeing time for the IT staff to focus on something more important and productive. Let's start with automation and see how it's done in Adaxes. Here I have a business rule that contains the onboarding procedures that take place automatically each time a new user account is created in Active Directory. And as you can see here, the first thing it does is it creates an Exchange mailbox for the new user. This particular action creates a mailbox in my on-premises Exchange, but Adaxes supports Office 365 as well. What I can do here is I can define how the mailbox alias is generated. Like in my case, it's set to the user's logon name. And I can also control how mailboxes are distributed across databases. For example, here only database 1 and database 3 are allowed. And Adaxes will pick the one that contains the least number of mailboxes, or you can use the round robin method instead. Using conditions, you can use more complicated criteria, like choose the database based on the first letter of the user's last name. Adaxes supports scenarios where user accounts and mailboxes are located in different forests, so linked mailboxes can also be created here in the same manner. Once a mailbox is created, my business rule will then execute another action to configure it. And as you can see, it allows me to modify practically any parameter of the mailbox, including Exchange custom attributes, storage quotas, calendar permissions, mailbox rights, policies, mailbox features, and others. This particular action will enable archiving for the mailbox. And with the help of conditions, you can apply different settings to different mailboxes. For example, in my case, the business rule will disable Exchange Active Sync if the employee type of the user equals temporary employee. And in addition to that, if a manager is specified for a user, the manager will be granted the send on behalf of permission on the mailbox. Now, let's switch to Adaxes web interface to actually create a new user in Active Directory to see how all that works. First, I need to fill in some details for the new user account, and also let's select the manager. And here we go. Once I click Finish, Adaxes will create a user account in AD, and then execute all the onboarding procedures we've just seen. And once completed, we can straight away see that an Exchange mailbox has been created for the user, archiving has also been enabled for this mailbox, and in addition to that, the manager has received permission to send emails on behalf of this user. All that was done automatically with absolutely no action required from my side. One thing you may have noticed here is that I can modify all the different Exchange properties straight from the web interface without having to switch to other tools, like Exchange Admin Center. All these options are available to me because I'm using the web interface for administrators and I have full admin rights in Adaxes. But if I switch to another web interface, like this one that I created for managers, as you can see, the UI here is much simplified and contains only what I want managers to see when viewing the mailboxes of their subordinates. Here is the configuration of that web interface. As you may notice, I can be very granular with what's displayed there. I can enable or disable entire sections, like mailbox usage or email addresses, individual policies, features, fields, and options. This level of customization enables you to provide a simple and clear UI for end users that will contain only what they need and hide everything else. And if a user isn't allowed to view or change something, it will be disabled or hidden from that user in the web interface. Adaxes allows you to control exactly which Exchange properties can be viewed and changed by which users, which is done with the help of security roles. For example, here I have a role for managers. This role allows them to configure out-of-office replies and mail tips, as well as modify individual fields like extension attribute 1 and the hide from address lists option. And again, as you can see, I can be very granular about what users can view and modify, up to individual fields and properties. But with Adaxes, you can go even further and create your own custom user interface commands for Exchange management tasks, which is really essential when it comes to delegation, especially if you want to delegate certain activities to non-technical users. Here I have a custom command that I created myself. And when I launch it, I can select what I want to do using these simple options, like turn on out-of-office replies, place the mailbox on retention hold, cancel all meetings organized by the user. And also here, I can change the manager of the user. And when I click OK, Adaxes will perform all the actions I selected in one go. And now, as you can see, out-of-office reply is enabled for the mailbox. It's placed on retention hold. And if we have a look at the mailbox rights, the send on behalf of permission has been revoked from the previous manager and assigned to the new one. All that in just a few mouse clicks. And finally, when a user is terminated, various actions need to take place as part of the offboarding process to deprovision the user's mailbox, which is also covered by Adaxes. Here is the deprovision command that comes pre-configured out of the box. Among a whole series of actions, it will set up mail forwarding so that all mail messages sent to the mailbox are forwarded to the user's manager, give the manager full access permission on the mailbox, hide the mailbox from exchange address lists, cancel all meetings organized by the user, convert the mailbox into a shared mailbox, which is especially useful if it's hosted in Office 365, as in this case, the mailbox will remain available even if you revoke all the licenses assigned to the user. And of course, all this can be customized to exactly meet all your specific needs and requirements. Now, if I go ahead and execute the custom command on a user, all the actions we've just seen will be performed instantly, without any delays or missteps. And here we go. The mailbox is now hidden from exchange address lists. All email messages are now forwarded to the user's manager. The mailbox has been converted into a shared mailbox. The manager has been granted full access to this mailbox, and so on. In addition to user mailboxes, with Adaxes, you can also manage other objects, like mail-enabled users, contacts, groups, shared mailboxes, equipment mailboxes, and room mailboxes. For instance, you can view or change when a conference room can be scheduled, how long it can be reserved for, who can accept or decline booking requests, configure calendar settings, and many other parameters of that kind. And also, Adaxes changes the way you work with linked mailboxes, as you don't need to separately manage master user accounts and the mailboxes they're linked to. Meaning that if a user has a linked mailbox, all the exchange properties and operations are available for the user account, just as if it had a regular mailbox. So, as you've seen in this video, Adaxes gives you all the tools and features you need to automate many of those time-consuming and boring tasks you deal with regularly. And those activities that can't be automated away can be carried out using an intuitive and easy-to-use interface, which also eliminates the need to constantly switch between different tools for AD and Exchange. And in addition to that, using Adaxes, you can delegate many different Exchange management tasks to non-technical staff, freeing up time for admins to focus on more important things. Thanks for watching.